taught for the Academic Bridge Program for 2 years here at Zayud University. I've taught Level 4, Level 5, and O2O. They're all Foundation students. O2O students are in their second tier of an 8-level program, and they are past beginner, past elementary, not quite pre-intermediate level. We've used the iPad for many interesting projects. The first one was a spontaneous one that I thought of just while we were in class one day. I was teaching a grammar point, there is and there are. And then I walked over to the windows and I said, there are some antique cars in our courtyard. One by one, the students came to the windows, and sure enough, there was our courtyard full of antique cars. So I gave them the assignment during the break that day to go to shoot some photos of the cars that they liked. When they came back in class, we would do an iPad-related project to it. So during the break, they shot with their camera and their iPad. Then when they came back, I introduced the grammar structure of there is and there are, and they wrote sentences to match their pictures. They put them together using PicCollage. It was a very engaging and enjoyable activity, and created on the spur of the moment. That's one of the things I really like about the iPad, is the students love to do the activities with it, and when there's something that happens that you didn't expect, you can create a lesson just like that, and off they go. Another interesting activity using the iPads was when we took a field trip to the Abu Dhabi Book Fair. They basically took photos of their favorite booths. They wrote sentences to match their photos and put it on PicCollage or Keynote. What surprised me about the results was they discovered things I would never have guessed they found at the book fair. They found a tree that had prizes on it. They found the children's corner, the chef's corner. I realized that if I had given them a worksheet that I prepared, then they would have learned what I wanted them to learn. But since they were able to make their own choices, they really enjoyed it, and they learned far more than I would have guessed if I hadn't seen their pictures and their text to match it. What the other teachers and I learned was that this project was very autonomous, and instead of being the directors, tried to be the facilitators to create an environment where they discovered things on their own. This book fair project showed that the students met two of the Zayud University learning outcomes. The first one is about critical thinking, where they're supposed to be able to explore and develop critical opinions. They had to make many choices while they were at the book fair and decide what they wanted to share about it. Another Zayud University learning outcome is information literacy, where the students are to find, evaluate, and use appropriate information from multiple sources. The book fair had over 1,000 exhibitors and booths, and from that montage of many, they had to choose the ones that appealed to them, that they learned something from, and that they found useful for their learning. We met that objective. I like using the iPad because the students get to show me their personality in ways I wouldn't have seen it if we were just writing sentences on paper. It's the way I used to teach. Now they get to add choices they've made with visual graphics and photos, and combining that with the text that they write is very engaging for them. It's student-centered, and it's very motivating for them. They really enjoy doing it. I think using the iPad really breaks down the classroom walls, because before, where it was just this teacher me and the students them and paper and pencil, and now we can bring all the outside things that they find and discover and share it with one another. It's very exploratory and discovery-centered learning for them. It's about their interests and what they're attracted to, and they find engaging, and I like watching it flourish and grow. And this is the kind of learning environment that Zayud University promotes.